Hi, I'm Rupert Graves, and I'm in a movie called Native. Great. I mean, I really support doing a low budget movie for this. Anything that kind of gets people involved in new films is great. So, very happy to be here. It's a sci-fi picture. It's basically two people in a spacecraft traveling an unfathomable distance, and it's kind of what happens to them and the story of what they are, who they are, and what they're up to becomes clear during the movie. Well, first of all, I only wanted to support a very small little movie. I thought the script was really tight, really intelligent, and it made me very, very curious. It kind of completely whetted my appetite, and I got when I read a script, I either really connect with it or I don't, and I just was really intrigued by it. We're living in the future, and it's a guy in the future. We're saying that these characters are somewhat programmed, mentally programmed, and it's a guy who hears music, celestial music, for the first time, and it disrupts the programming and his humanity, or his kind of organic nature, is stimulated and comes out, and it's massively at odds with the rest of his mental programming, and it's against he's on a mission, and it adversely affects the mission.
Of course, you're working with a beautiful young co-star in Ellie. Can you talk about that experience, what she was like to work with?
Well, she was fantastic. I hadn't worked with her before, I didn't know her before, but it was basically us two in a studio. I loved her, yeah, she was fantastic, absolutely fantastic.
Of course, we're here at the East End Festival celebrating particularly independent cinema. What do you think independent cinema gives audiences they perhaps don't get from other kinds of cinema?
I think with the big cinemas coming out of studios, they have so many often commercial considerations, and those can sometimes help, and sometimes they can eat at the integrity of a movie. But it's certainly an independent cinema, as we all know, just gives the filmmaker so much more independence and clarity of vision. I think they're much more easily able to create their vision.
Fans can't wait for more Sherlock. I guess, what's it been like working on the new series for that?
Great. I think these are the best scripts, actually. I think especially they're the best scripts. I was kind of worried that maybe the scripts, it's very difficult when you're doing TV series to keep the quality up. But these are, for me, the best scripts, I think. I'm a big fan of lead, especially with Sherlock, with the stories that lead the audience by the nose through the narrative. These really do that, and they've also, just a personal preference, are quite dark, but I really like that too. So,
do you think that obviously now that Ben and Martin have had that benefit of the time to live with these characters, that it's given perhaps an extra dimension to things this season?
I think so, yeah, and I think, and also the fans' relationship with the characters too is broadened and deepened too, so, yeah. I don't mind the fact that he's kind of slightly peripheral, because I think he's the one that, shows what policing is and is there as a kind of benchmark for Sherlock's brilliance, really, in a way. I've been very happy with the way it's evolved.
Talking about brilliance, was it a brilliant pleasure to work with Toby Jones, another fantastic talent?
Yeah, I love Toby's, his acting is incredible. I love his dad too, Freddie Jones. I think he's an amazing, both of them are incredible actors. And I only had one scene with Toby, unfortunately, but I'm a big fan of his. I've been to Comic-Con in San Diego, and I've seen people, the amount of effort people go to dress up as characters. On social media, you see the extraordinary paintings that people do, and the fan fiction around, which is extraordinary. I mean, I love that very symbiotic nature of the audience to the program. I love the way that it actually excites the creativity within the audience. I think that's a really wonderful thing. Right, the point we were raising earlier is that independent films can You'll see a whole host of stories and ideas and ways of doing films which are outside the norm. And so it kind of opens the door to possibilities, independent film. And I think this film achieves that. It does. I mean, when you look at the budget, which is 30,000 quid, and they've made a good sci-fi movie, using ideas and cunning. If you want to be excited and see new things, go and see independent movies.